Hello everyone. Thank you for attending the St. Louis Art Museum's virtual Pok Jumeoni or Fortune Pouch demonstration presented in partnership with the Gateway Korea Foundation. My name is Jessica Kennedy and I'm the educator for adult learning at the St. Louis Art Museum. Before we begin, please familiarize yourself with the Q&A section located on your screen. Feel free to enter your questions at any time during the program and we will choose a few to answer at the end. There's also live auto transcription available for this program. Please click the CC icon to activate or deactivate the subtitles. For today's demonstration, we are joined by Korean-born artist Youngmin Lee, who is joining us tonight from the San Francisco Bay Area. Youngmin holds a master's degree in fashion design and a bachelor's degree in clothing and textiles. After she moved to California with her family in 1996, she started creating textile art by hand stitching and sewing. She chose bojagi, or Korean wrapping cloth, as her creative medium and presented workshops at the Asian Art Museum of San Francisco, Oakland Museum, Los Angeles County Museum of Art, Society for Contemporary Craft in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, the DeYoung Museum, and many more. Youngmin's works have been exhibited and collected throughout the United States and abroad. Thank you so much for being with us today, Youngmin.
Thank you so much for having me. Let me start my video. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Dano celebration today, and good evening, and maybe good afternoon, and maybe good morning. I'm Youngmin Lee. I'm happy to be here today to share Korean tradition and culture with you. Thank you to Gateway Korea Foundation and St. Louis Art Museum for inviting me. As a part of Dano Spring Festival program, I'd like to share how to make a simple Jumeoni pouch with you. Before we start to make, let me talk about saekdong briefly. Saekdong is colorful fabric pieces sewn like a stripe and used for sleeves of children's jacket, jeogori or jumagi. Saek means color and dong means a stripe or a unit of fabric piece. Saekdong was used as a striped sleeves and decoration in color or front of jackets. Bright colors that were used in saekdong are obangsaek, five directional colors, such as red, blue, yellow, white, and black. Black was not often used to children's clothing though. And some ogansaek, pink, purple, violet, green, and brown. So by using these bright colors, people look for more happiness and good luck and health and longevity. And they wanted to protect their children from evil spirits. Let me go to the next slide. And this is one example that you can see from early 1900 to 1950 in Korea. There was one family who lived in Korea during that time, noble family, and their children wore these saekdong, jeogori, and bajian outfit. And this is Asian Art Museum in San Francisco's collection. And I thought maybe I can share some of my family album with you. So these are the pictures that someone is wearing saekdong. You can see my husband's first birthday outfit, and my brother and I are there. And you can even see my daughter's first birthday picture. So these are from 1960s to 1990s. And saekdong was also used in different ways to decorate children's outfits, like shoes and socks. And today's topic, Jumeoni. Jumeoni is a pouch that you can carry and put things. Since traditional Korean clothes don't have pockets, Korean people carry the Jumeoni to carry their belongings. And Jumeoni is a drawstring pouch made from fabrics or paper or sometimes leather. There are many kinds of pouches, as you can see. And you also can see I was using saekdong in some pouches, Jumeoni. So these are brief story about saekdong. And I will show you some examples of saekdong and Jumeoni from now on. These are gochujumeoni that we will make today. But before we start, I'd like to show you some other examples of Jumeoni. So this is Jumeoni that we will make. And as I mentioned, there are different types of Jumeoni. The round shape one is called durujumeoni. And I used some saekdong colors in my Jumeoni. And this one is a big one. And this is different type of Jumeoni. It is called gwijumeoni. These have angular shape that resembles human ears. Like each Jumeoni has two ears on each side. So these are called the gwijumeoni. And there are different kinds too. These Jumeoni are called yakjumeoni because people used to use this Jumeoni to put medicine inside. So this one I pasted with the small colorful fabrics, and this one is the print one. And I made a small one so I can carry a little bit of lavender seeds, flowers, so I can use it as a sachet. So these are different types of Jumeoni. And we will make quot moyang Jumeoni today. So now I will make Jumeoni with you. So if you can watch me, then we can learn how to make Jumeoni. So these are two pre-cut fabrics. One is saekdong, backside of saekdong, and front is like this. And the other one is thin silk gauze that I can use as a lining. So the size of this fabric is, this one is 10 inch square with half an inch seam allowance on each corner for size. And I will leave a little bit as an opening when I stitch. If you want to make bigger one, you can cut bigger square. Using 10 inch square, you will make this size Jumeoni. And if you cut fabrics a little bigger, like 12 inches, then you will get bigger one like this. So any size square fabrics, two pieces of square fabrics will make Jumeoni. So let's stitch now. As you can see, I draw the outline that I will stitch. So using the guideline, I will stitch around using partial back stitch or very fine running stitch. So this is the one that I already did and ironed. So partial back stitch looks like a running stitch, but the back side is connected like this. So it's pretty sturdy technique. And I can show you how to do it on the fabric so you can see. I am not going to stitch all the way around. I will just do a little bit so you can see what it is. So the start, I will do a back stitch, regular back stitch like this. And then as I go, I will do, the needle goes back to toward the starting point, but not all the way to the back, just part, half of it, and then move to this direction. And then I will go back and stitch. So needle goes, the needle direction is from right to the left. Right to the left. Right to the left like this. So you can see it from the top. It looks like a running stitch. Running stitch is like this. Up and down, up and down. But when you see it from the back, you can see partial back stitch is connected. And running stitch is same effect, front and back. So you can guess this is a sturdier, stronger stitch technique. So using this technique, I already stitched it around and I ironed the stitched line toward the sekdong side, which is outside. And then I will put my finger inside to turn, excuse me, these two fabrics turn inside out. In order to do that, I will fold the corner, fold the other corner, and hold with my thumb like this, and then turn inside out. Then I will get really nice corner. So I will repeat all the corners. And the last one is here. As you can see, sekdong is kind of thick silk fabric, so it's not too slippery. It's not too thin, so it's easy to stitch with. So once I turned inside out, I will iron it again with silk setting, which is low to medium set. Because you don't want to damage your silk fabric. And we will iron over here one more time to get nice line. And then we will close this gap, the opening. And I prepared this one that I already stitched and st- started with needle and thread. So we will do blind hem stitch, which is taking a little bit from inside of the fabric like this. Because this part doesn't have to be super strong. As long as you can close the gap, that is good enough. But if this technique is too hard or too difficult to do it, then you can do simply whip stitch, 감침질, which is stitching two layers together from back to the front, back to the front, back to the front. And you don't see much of stitch marks in here. So this is easier way to finish if you are not comfortable or familiar with the blind hem stitch. So I will do a couple more stitches. And then I will finish it by stitching only back layer and making a knot and hide a knot inside. After that, we will trim it off. Like this. So now we got two pieces of fabrics. We started from two layers like this and stitched around and turned inside out and closed the opening like this. And now it's time to make a decision if you want to make Jumeoni, the Saekdong stripe part outside, then you can fold like this. And if you want to have solid color outside and have Saekdong a little bit, then you can fold this direction. So there are two different ways, but I like to show more Saekdong, so I will use this side. So thinking about folding fortune teller with paper. You fold one corner, two corners, three, and four. Like this. After that, let me bring iron a little closer so I can easily grab it. After that, we will fold one more set of 1, 2, 3, 4 corners toward outside like this. And I have one that I made over here. I folded toward the outside and ironed it. And as you can see, drawstring pouch needs a space to put string. So after I fold it, I mark the line from inside toward the pointy part, 1/2 inch all the way around. Four corners. I'm using fabric pencil that I can erase it after I finish. Now we will stitch the marked side using that partial back stitch again. Let me get a thread and show you So we will only stitch the top and second layer. We are not gonna stitch the bottom because we only need to make casing with two top layers. So I got a needle and thread and tie a knot. And then we can start from this side. I will start from here to here. Sorry. If you want, you can put a clip to this fold stay well. And from the down inside, I will start. At the beginning, I might do two stitches to secure the end. And then I can move on to the next part. And do partial backstitch, 반박음질 in Korean. 반 means half, and 박음질 means backstitch. So again, when you see the back part is connected. You want to make strong stitches, strong seam when you do the casing because you will pull your string all the time when you close the opening of Jumeoni. So at the end, again, I will do maybe two stitches. So they can hold well. Then I will move my needle toward the back of this tiny triangle. And I will tie a knot and hide my knot somewhere in between layers. Like this. So we will repeat those four steps. I demonstrated one line over here and I prepared another one that I already did 1, 2, 3 corners lines. And I will do one more over here. Show you 반박음질 one more time. Always hide the knot and two stitches at the beginning and then little tiny 반박음질, partial backstitch. All the way to the other side. If you have any question about any steps, you can ask me later or please ask, type on the chat box. Couple more stitches to the end, think I can do two stitches right at the end. And then just move the needle to the back of tiny fold and tie a knot. And move my needle one more time. And trim it. So now we finished stitching 1, 2, 3, 4 lines. And I'd like to remove my marks before I do the string part. So now we will need a cord. Use a medup cord. Medup is Korean knots, Korean knotting. It is decorative knot that I do at the end of the cord. So once cord string will start from here and go all the way around and come out here. And the second one, move on to the diagonal direction. And then I will start from here and come back. So we can use two cords as a drawstring. And as you can see, I attach it a pin at the end of my cord, which will help me travel through the casing. Once you come back to the starting point, you can take out the pin. Here's one set, and I will move on to the diagonal direction. And I will do the same step, just from different direction. Three, and the last casing that I go through. Like this, and take out the pin. Now I have two strings, two cords, in one side and two on the other side. And we can close it like this. But before we close it, let's make a knot. I made small knots when I finish my Jumeoni. And sometimes I do a little more elaborate knots like this. This one is samjeongja. It's a lattice shape. And this one is butterfly. And another butterfly with tassel here. And this one is called chrysanthemum. And ring knots. And this tiny one is called dragonfly, which has two sets of wings and body. Today I will do simple knot called dore and sengjok. Dore is a beginning of all the Korean knots. It is a double cross shape, very strong knot. So front and back are both cross shape. And then I will do sengjok. Sengjok means a piece of ginger. So let's make sengjok. I teach this medup class too because medup and bojagi are inseparable. They always help each other and they go well together. So can you see a piece of ginger here? Then I will finish with dore again. Like this. Usually I stop right at this point, but since I have little long cord left, I might do one more dore so you can see one more time. So take the right one, right cord, and then make a loop. Go through it and move the crossed part toward the left side. And make another loop and go through it and pull the first one and the second one like this. So let's go to the other side and I will make one more set. Medup is difficult to learn, but once you learn it, there are so many ways that you can use. So if you like to make something with your hand, please try Korean medup, which is really challenging, but very fun. So I made another sengjok, piece of ginger. And I will do two more dore here. One more. So I'm done making it and I will finish it by measuring and trim it and pull out the white part. Metalcord always have white cotton inside. And you don't want to show that. So I will pull out a little bit and trim it. Pull out a little bit and trim it. So now we are done making it. And when you close it, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4 flower petals around the jaekdong jumeoni part. So this is why it is called 꽃주머니. It is 복주머니. 복주머니 means jumeoni that carries fortune and happiness. So you can apply 복주머니 to all the jumeoni. And this one especially has 1, 2, 3, 4 petals in the middle. So I call it 꽃주머니, flower-shaped jumeoni. Like this. So we just finished making 꽃주머니. And I have different sizes. If you flatten it, it will show 1, 2, 3, 4 petals and a little bit of stand up part. And if you put something inside, it will keep its shape better. So let's put my spool of thread in here. It keeps the shape better. And for the bigger one, maybe I can put something bigger. Maybe I can put my pin magnet in here. And you can see when I put, oh, this one is a small one too. When I put something with size and weight, and you can see jumeoni turns into kind of three-dimensional shape. Let's put another pin. Magnet in the smaller jumeoni. And sometimes people carry their own teacup in this tiny jumeoni. But you can put anything you want. So this is how I make 꽃주머니. And as I mentioned, 2 pieces of square fabric will make this one. And simple folding and simple stitching is required, but nothing is that difficult. So I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you can make your own when you have time.
Wonderful. Thank you, Youngmin.
Oh, you're welcome, Jessica.
We have several questions. So if you're, mm-hmm. are you ready for some questions? And I'm going to leave your demonstration space big, so in case that's helpful. So let's see. Someone would like to know what type of sewing thread, silk, cotton, or a poly blend?
When I sew silk fabric, I use silk thread. And 50 weight silk thread is the best for hand stitching. And when I stitch around the 4 lines, I use the 50 weight silk thread. But when I do partial back stitch for the casing, I use the slightly thicker one, which is, I think it's 30 weight. That's the number.
Okay.
So number gets smaller, the thread gets thicker.
Okay.
And you can easily get it. And when I use cotton or linen or rayon fabric, then I use natural fiber, which is cotton thread.
Okay. Let's see. So for the one that you had been using during most of the demonstration, what were the size of the squares that you started with? And then what was the size of the finished product? Someone was wondering.
Let's see. This was my sample, or most of my sample. And these are 10 by 10 inch by 10 inch cut with half an inch seam allowances. So the finished stitched line will be 9 inch square. Here's my ruler. Yes, 9 inch. So after you finish stitching around, it will be 9 by 9, and it will turn into this. Let's measure this, Jumeoni. Okay. Take out the thread. So this is silk thread. And let's see. This one is little over 6 inch by 6 1/4. And it is not flat because it has a little bit of wonkiness because of the layers, but it will be around 6 1/4 inch square. And okay. The opening is about 3 inch square.
Great. Someone else was wondering where you can get these materials. And I was actually kind of wondering the same thing is, mm-hmm. You know, are you able to easily find that in the US?
Actually, Saekdong or any other Korean silk fabrics are kind of difficult to get in the US. So I travel to Korea every year and I buy a lot. So I can bring it back and I can share with my students and people who want to buy. Yeah, right. So if you really want to get Korean silk or Saekdong, you can email me. I'm happy to help you.
There we go. And yeah. I will be sharing Youngmin's website and Instagram in a minute in the chat. So, and I think her email address is on her website somewhere. So you can contact mm-hmm. her through that. Let's see. Someone said, you mentioned obang. Can you talk uh-huh. about that and how it is different from Saedong?
Obang is literally means five direction. O means five and bang means direction. So obang sek is five colors that represent four directions and a center. So I'm just thinking east is blue and west is white and north is black and south is red and the middle is yellow.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. We have a few questions about how these have been traditionally used. So someone has asked how were these carried on men's and women's traditional clothing? Mm-hmm. And then also, would people ever carry more than one at a time? So, you know, different items in different pouches all at once.
I think so. I think people can carry more than one, but I don't exactly remember seeing it from the picture, but in the old paintings, mm-hmm. at least one Jumeoni is worn. And since it has a string or cord or strap like this, you can wear it, you can tie it on your waist, mm-hmm. belt sash. And for women, you have long skirt that is tightened right above your chest mm-hmm. with tie. So using that tie, you can lighter one. You can use the string and tie it on that tie. So let me show you one example. I found, while I was preparing this, I found my daughter's 저고리, 색동 저고리. That she wore when she was a year old, first birthday. And this is jacket, 저고리, actually 당의 special jacket with the 색동. And here's her skirt. So she wear underneath like this. And when you see the skirt, here are two straps that you can wear over your shoulder, and you can tie it with this tie or sash. So when you are wearing jumeoni, then you can use your string to tie.
Okay.
Or just go through just one side like this.
Oh, wow, yeah.
And then you can tie it. So that's how people were wearing jumeoni with them.
Yeah, that's very helpful. That visual is very helpful. That makes a lot of sense.
I see, yeah. And I think men also had sashi around their waist. So they were tying jumeoni on their waist sash.
Okay.
To secure it. And here's another 색동 that I really want to share with everybody. This is my jacket that I wore sometime, long time ago. Maybe when I was maybe 7 or 8. So it's very old and kind of soiled 저고리, but you can see.
But the colors are 저고리. Still so bright.
Yeah, and you can see some auspicious patterns like longevity and either bat or butterfly and some kind of flower, simplified flower patterns. And these are very old, not very old, but 40 something years old one. And this is brand new 색동 that I got from Korea only a couple of years ago, but you can see
the
auspicious very symbols similar. And colors are very similar. Yeah. And I hope they still, they keep making this fabric because less and less people are making this. Yeah.
Is it difficult to find in Korea yet?
I still can find it, and there is one special, one store specially carry this silk saekdong, and people who love fabric like me, they all know where to go. And that is one of few stores in Seoul.
Right, it's very, very popular. Okay, let me do a really quick, I think that actually that is all the time we have for our questions. Before we go, I do want to put in your website and Instagram into the chat so people can find you. And then I also want to put the Gateway Korea Foundation's website, because there is more Dano Festival programming, virtual programming. Yeah. That Youngmin is going to be a part of as well. So if you're interested in participating in more virtual Dano Festival programs, you can join us again on Friday, June 18th at 7 p.m., where scholar Lee Talbot will be talking about traditional Korean women's textiles. And then on Saturday, June 19th at 7 p.m., Youngmin will be joined by Lee Talbot and Edna Patterson Petty, who is a textile artist specializing in African-American textile arts. And they will all be discussing African-American, Korean, and East Asian textile arts altogether. So if you want to learn more about that, go ahead and click on the Gateway Korea Foundation website that I've included there. And for the program on Friday, you can also find that on the museum's website as well. So thank you so much, Youngmin. This was Fabulous. And I just want to thank everyone else for joining us this evening.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me. And I hope to see everybody on Friday and Saturday again. Thank you.
Yes, thank you. Thanks, everyone. have a great evening or afternoon.
Okay. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.